I thought perhaps you missed the exit for the lodge. So wonderful to see you. I certainly hope you are ready for this unique party I've arranged. You see, I met this Madame Lewinsky at one of her club meetings a month ago, and well, now it's a who's who of Hollywood in my house. Won't you please come in? Miss Hopkins, here are the rest of our guests.
How marvelous. What a pleasure to meet you all. Please do sit down. We'll begin in just a few minutes.
My dear Mrs. Ellis, this house is amazing. It has inspired me. I'm working on a new screenplay, and I would like to use the stories you have told me as its theme and inspiration.
Well, thank you, Mr. Thompson. I'm sure it will win you another Oscar.
Only if it has Betty in the starring role, of course.
Yes, Audrey. She is certainly the greatest actress in the country today. And, of course, I'm sure she will have a bit part for you in the production, as always.
As always.
Oh, Errol, don't be such a prude. Everyone knows that the supporting actresses are just as important as the main stars.
And Audrey is natural.
Oh, Mr. White, the pendant you're wearing is simply stunning.
Oh, this old thing.
Well, my dear departed husband left me a fortune after his death. But most of his wealth really resides in the jewelry that he left me. This is the Earl of Whitby Black Diamond. It is said to become off of the coast of Robin Hood's Bay.
Robin Hood's Bay? Isn't that near North Rockmore's?
Yeah, it is.
Francis speaks. Tall drink of water with a bit of bite, he is.
I don't see anything wrong with that.
I'd like you to meet Luella Chase. This is Betty DeWhite.
It is an honor to meet you, Mrs. DeWhite. I've enjoyed many of your motion pictures.
Thank you, Captain. You are too kind.
Mrs. Ellis, if you don't mind,
Madame would like to begin.
The spirits are beginning to stir.
Yes, yes. Everyone, please sit down.
What fun.
Let's enjoy the pious broad.
Tonight, Madame Lewinsky will open the divide between the living and the dead. However, to invite those from the great beyond into the circle, we must have the utmost silence.
Close your mind to any doubts, focusing your energies on being open to communication. Do not be afraid. Please place your hands, palms up, on the table or your knees. Close your eyes and breathe. Keep your eyes closed. Imagine your mind wandering through the darkness of time and roam with me back to the time of the ancient seas, to a time when the sun was new. Journey back to when the spirits walked the earth, to when the old gods roamed from heaven to earth. Breathe and keep your eyes closed. I call forth the Mother Goddess. I call forth the dead to speak to us. We mean no harm to you or us, dear spirits. Come to me. Come to me. We only want to speak with you. Come to me. Let me know who you are.
Is that smell?
Someone is here. Oh. My name is Patty. It's been a long time since I walked these halls. Where are my parents? Everything looks so different. I remember coming back from Barbados. My health was poor. I was a sickly child. But I loved so many things. My Aunt Nancy, how I loved her. She was an excellent flute player. She loved music and me. Alas, I did not see her. She was so sad. I heard her crying. I did not mean to die. It was dark. So dark. So cold. You're not alone. Who are you? Why are you here? Why are you standing in the shadows? Leave me alone! You are free to go to the light. The circle is closed.
Oh my, how exciting. Holly was one of the Blackburn's daughters, I believe. She died young.
Well, it was interesting. Has anyone seen Miss Weston?
Miss Dwight, where's your diamond?
What? It's been stolen!
Audrey took it.
No, she wouldn't. We'll find it and her. Let's search the house. Mr. Kang, will you stay here with the ladies while Mr. Thompson, the captain, and I search the house?
I heard a scream from all over there. I think I better go and use off the ear.
I don't think it's necessary to be waving that gun around, Mr. Cagney. Dessie and I will be going with you.
I think it best if I stay here. I'll ask these ladies if they have anything to do with this.
Sir, what are you insinuating? I am not a thief.
No, of course not, madame. We will deal with this later, Mr. Thompson. Let's check the house and see if we can find Miss Rustin.
Thieves and charlatans are often found in the same breath, along with their puppets. Can't let you, let's make sure you're both close to.
I just wanted to help calm you nerves.
Hokey for me. I came out. Something startled me. I heard something. And then everything went back. Black. Oh, my head hurts.
We should get her back to the parlor. I will phone the sheriff and see how soon he can come.
I look for a diamond. Do you have Mr. White diamond?
What are you talking about? She's wearing it.
No, she ain't. Someone swiped it.
What? That's impossible! Is she okay?
She's fine, just a little shaken up. Let's get you back to the others. Something very suspicious is going on here.
Yes. I will lock this door, and then I'll check with my chauffeur to see if you've seen anyone or heard anything. And then I will phone the sheriff.
Don't take too long.
Thank you for your concern, Mr. County. I won't.
I think I hear them coming back.
Audrey! Where were you? I thought you were sick. And then I blacked out.
More like someone hit on the head.
Convenient.
Errol, how could you say such things? She could have been kidnapped or killed.
Betty, please, spare me the dramatics. She's clearly drunk. Look at her. She was three drinks in before the seance even began. She probably heard something, went inside to investigate, bumped her head, and she knocked herself out. She's obviously drunk.
Errol! How could you say such horribly wicked things? Honestly, you are wicked.
Then why are you marrying him?
What?
I was going to wait to announce it before we return to California. But yes, Errol asked me to marry him, and I said yes. Although I'm beginning to rethink my decision.
But, please, that's not rash. I'm sorry. It's just, you know how I feel about Audrey. She's been riding her coattails for years. If it wasn't for you, she wouldn't even have a career.
And neither would you.
You think you're such a big man about town? Measly, pathetic, forgettable movies. She's the only reason they get made. If it wasn't for her being a guaranteed starring role, they would never get made. She's the only reason anyone pays attention to you. How arrogant you are.
Why you?
I have phoned the sheriff and he will arrive shortly. He has also sent for the doctor. Perhaps you should lie down until he arrives.
Yes. There are other pockets.
I think we should wait for the sheriff.
Then no one leaves the room.
We would need to wait for the sheriff to begin investigating.
How? We're gonna wait for a country bumpkin with a bat to solve this. It seems obvious that he did it.
I take offense to that, Mr. Kennedy. Sheriff Jones is a very astute man and thorough, not some country bumpkin.
Besides, we're all suspects, including you.
Although Mr. Thompson is a difficult man, the spirits tell me he is innocent of murder.
Right now, I don't care about those spirits. He did, I just know it.
Well, not so fast. We were all here, except for one, during the seance. Therefore, in my mind, it is much more likely that Ms. Rustin is a victim versus a guilty party. Mr. Thompson here could either be the fall guy, the real thief, or the potential murderer.
Yes, we are all suspects. Any of us could have taken the diamond. An autopsy would be required to determine how Miss Rustin died.
Yes, that's true. She seemed fine when we brought her back in, and there was no indication that her injuries were so severe. Miss Dwight claimed that she was gasping and making choking noises. It sounds like it could be a possible asphyxiation.
Logically, one could suspect that some sort of poison was introduced to her body, or she had an allergic reaction to something she ate. Either way, sister, we must take care.
Yes. Well, all she had was a little bit of alcohol before the seance, and then some water when she came back that Miss Dwight gave her. I don't think she would have poisoned her own friend.
Absolutely not. Audrey was more than my best friend. She was like a sister to me.
Oh, her water glass is still here. Let's look.
It smells like water. It seems that there's some material here at the bottom of the glass. It hasn't dissolved yet.
This is truly a horrible, tragic night. If that is indeed poison, then someone has killed an innocent person in my house. Wade and I will not stand for this. They will be brought to justice.
Worry not, Dessie. We will find out who would dare do this. The sheriff will be here shortly.
Oh, if Audrey didn't take the diamond, then someone else did. This person is desperate.
And that would mean that possibly Audrey was not the person the thief was trying to poison.
Who gave her the water?
I did. I got it from Miriam.
Well, I just got it from the table over there. It had already been poured, but I didn't think anything of it. I gave it to Ms. Dwight to help calm her nerves when she realized her jewel was missing.
Yes, indeed. You're being awfully quiet, Mr. Thompson.
Yes, I've been thinking. Who would have had the opportunity to poison the water for my dear Betty? Who wanted to kill her? It's unconscionable.
Oh, Audrey, it's because of me that she's gone!
There, Mr. White, we will figure out who did this.
Now, there's a thief that was only a rare jewel, and furthermore, they might be guilty of bumping off Audrey. It's someone in this room. The killer is one of us.
Then perhaps we should do as you suggested, Mr. Cagney.
And what's that?
Have everyone empty their pockets and clutches.
I think I'd rather wait for the sheriff for this.
Nothing to hide, then why wait? You are her fiance, after all. She is your leading lady. Why would you have reason to kill her?
Yeah, she still the meal ticket.
Well, that's enough from you!
Francis, please!
I'm sorry, Mrs. I don't like him.
Where is that blasted sheriff? Oh, I need a drink.
Stop!
That drink is poisoned.
How do you know?
I saw Miriam take Mr. Thompson's glass and leave her own.
What if I did? It's an honest mistake.
Nonsense. I know the truth. You deliberately took Mr. Thompson's glass and left your own drink for him to take. A drink he did not touch all evening.
That's not true. You're mistaken, madam. I took a sip.
And
she said she's a little old and nearsighted.
In fact, you gave the other drink to Miss Dwight. Fortunately for you, the spirits protected you.
That's my fault.
She did not drink it.
That's not possible. She's been by your side of the room ever since we got here.
Why would I poison the drinks? This is mad!
Always so helpful. see her latest movie multiple times wherever we went. So suspicious. Remember when we first arrived in Washington, D.C.? You kept disappearing every afternoon. She said she was going to see the artwork and tour the town. And yet you never had any souvenirs. And you were always so vague with your answers when I asked what you had seen.
So much to see. We've never been good with details.
Oh, hush! You write everything down. I noticed these things. I remember seeing you with a man in the gardens the other day.
Who do you think she saw, madam?
It was him. He had a hat and coat on, but his walk is very distinct. They were hiding behind some bushes, but I could see they were having a heated argument. Her hand touched your face.
You got it wrong, lady.
Frances, what is she talking about? You and Miss Hopkins?
Miriam, you served me, yourself, Mrs. Ellis, and Mr. Thompson, all drinks as we were talking. You knew we would begin as soon as everyone arrived. Plenty of time to put something into the drinks.
You did hand Betty the drink which she gave to Audrey.
This is silly. Why would I want to kill Mr. White or Miss Rustin?
Where is the diamond?
The diamond? I don't have it.
Then who does, Miss Hopkins?
How should I know? This is all wrong.
Mr. Candy, turn out your pockets.
Oh, thanks. So.
My God! She strong-armed the gun right out of his hand!
You do that? I've always been so good to you.
Because he didn't deserve the money. She did, as your husband's rightful heir.
Paul Dwight was my father.
That's impossible. Paul said he didn't have any children.
He lied. He was married to my mother before he left New York for Los Angeles. He went to Hollywood to become a big star. He said he'd bring us with him when he made it, but he made it, and then he fell in love with you, and then he forgot all about us.
You're wrong.
Don't be thick. Why do you think he always went back to New York without you?
How are you involved with this, Cagney?
Oh, well, there is my gal. We've known each other since grade school. Our ma had never talked about her father. And when I got the gig to be a bodyguard for Mr. White, she was furious with me. But I learned the truth.
All I wanted is what's rightfully mine, and then your stupid friend got in the way.
How so, Miss Hopkins?
She heard Frances on the phone with me. It took a little doing, but we got her to help.
No, Audrey would never.
But she did. All to have her to help. She was always in your shadows.
She knew that you asked the studio to keep her away from leading roles. She despised you both. She willingly staged her accident to cause a distraction. She is the better actress, after all.
Then why can't her?
She wasn't supposed to get the drink. The White was.
Yeah, because I wanted to frame him!
Me? Why me?
Because if you were convicted of killing Ms. Dwight, you are intended that you'd never get your greasy hands on my money.
They aren't married yet.
Yeah, they may have changed the will a week ago. I witnessed it.
Well, that's absurd.
If you have the diamond, then who does? Empty your pockets.
My Betty.
If you loved me, you would empty your pockets.
Fine, if it'll make you happy. There's my cigarettes. And there's my pocket watch and the key to the automobile. And that. Oh my. Where did that get in there? You must understand. The studio. They said they wouldn't film my next picture. And I spent all my money on the last one. And.
Good.
involved heard enough. I advise you all not to speak any further. Sit down!
Ah, there. The sheriff is coming up the drive. Like...
You know, it's too bad you two aren't actors. This would make one devil of a good picture.
Yeah. From any other director, I've seen your movies. They're crummy.
Oh, shut up.